Welcome back to American Air Gunner, and today we are talking Air Arms. This is the TDR S510 XS. We'll be looking at that and more today on American Air Gunner. All right, as we dig into the TDR, let's begin by giving you just a little bit of a history lesson. Air Arms, it's a company name that is synonymous with both quality and beauty. For any of you that are not familiar with it, they are a British air gun company that was founded in the late 80s. And let us not forget that their products have also been on the winning side of many an air gun competition as well. What we have here today in front of us is the Air Arms TDR S510 XS in 22 caliber. Now, the special portion of this rifle is stated right in the name TDR, which stands for take down rifle. The Air Arms TDR is designed to be easily taken down by removing the shoulder stock. And then this allows, of course, for easier transportation and packability in a smaller case. Now, many of you are probably wondering if this rifle can also be used as a long pistol if you remove the stock. And in short, no, the rifle becomes inoperable without the rear stock attached. So just some information for you as a side note. This version of the TDR S510 XS can be purchased in either a ambidextrous walnut stock, or as we see here, this very nice and very soft black soft touch stock. It's available in 177/22, has a built-in five-step adjuster right here. You can see it right here. And what's nice, if you're familiar with some of the older S510 models, this one clicks into place so you're not gonna bump it out, and it's easy to find that repeatable spot each and every time. Has a Q-Tec moderator, two-stage trigger, fully shrouded Lothar Walther barrel, comes with a hard case, and yes, two magazines. Another aspect that this rifle doesn't really discuss in great detail is that it's perfect for carrying around for youth who may not be comfortable holding up a full-length rifle, or anyone that wants a rifle that handles well and won't wear you out. Now, those of you who have been shooting air guns for any period of time will know that Air Arms released an unregulated version of this rifle in the past. And as I mentioned earlier, the XS in the name stands for extra shots, perhaps. I'm not sure what it stands for, but it does signify that this is a regulated air gun. And this newest version is definitely a step up from the previous iteration of this. And there is a huge performance boost with the factory regulator being installed. Whereas before, when I shot Air Arms, you know, you'd follow the traditional bell curve and throughout the entire fill, and shots would fall at the end of the cycle. But the TDR now has a very consistent, very flat shot string right out of the box. What is up, air gunners? We're down at the range right now. I'm looking at the Air Arms TDR in 22 caliber. Now, TDR, as I mentioned earlier, stands for take down rifle, and that's because you can take this down and pack it away in a smaller area. This air rifle has been around for a while, but this is the new version with a regulator included, so your shots are going to be even more consistent than they were before. This air gun is a proven winner on the field target circuit as well, and you know what, the quality, the fit, the finish, absolutely gorgeous. Also, it has not been pellet fussy for me at all at 50 yards. So I've gone ahead, got my target down there at 50 yards. Let's go ahead and see what we can do. And first though, I'm gonna hit a couple silhouette targets, get myself dialed in. Woo! 50 yards, this makes it easy. Let's go ahead and see what we can do. Five shot group down here. Now remember, I'm doing group shots, so I am just about a half a mil, shooting about half a mil shorter or lower than where I am aiming.
Okay,
Now in my testing of this particular rifle, remember each and every one is gonna be a little bit different when you take it out of the box, is getting 20 extremely consistent shots using the 22 caliber JSB 18.13 grain pellets. The regular and valve combination in this rifle had me shooting with a standard deviation, get this, of 3.1 feet per second, an average velocity of 881 feet per second. Ah, should have waited just a hair longer. And this all equates to around 31 foot-pounds of energy at the muzzle. Now, this is a perfect air gun for squirrel hunting, a day of plinking at the range, or even 177, I bet this would rock it out on a field target course too. Of course, I topped this TDR S510 XS, remember the XS stands for regulated, with a Hawk Sidewinder 30 first focal plane scope. And I love these first focal plane scopes. Now, I set the targets out to 50 yards and I was easily able to get sighted in. And my jaw just hit the ground when this group was produced shortly after getting sighted in. And the ease at which I was able to produce the group like this in such a short amount of time really does speak to the quality produced by Air Arms. Now, what Airgunner wouldn't be happy with a group measuring just 0.2895 inches center to center in only 30 minutes at the range. This was one happy air gunner. Now, what makes the Air Arms TDR S510 XS so accurate? Well, as I mentioned earlier, it does have a Lothar Walther barrel and a regulator. But beyond that, it does also have an outstanding match grade trigger. Now, a smooth light trigger can make all the difference in your ability to keep shots on target because you're not going to pull or push the rifle side to side. Testing the trigger on the bench, I was also very pleased and found it to have a nice and short first stage with a crisp break for that second stage, which all shooters are looking for. I had to test it. Let's get some numbers on it. 5 consecutive pulls from this unaltered, unadjusted air gun resulted in an average pull weight of just 6.4 ounces. And that felt very safe. It wasn't something that I was feeling like it might go off at any moment. So it was well set from the factory. Now, also remember that if this is not to your standard, you can go heavier or lighter because this is adjustable at your home shop. I want to draw your attention to an additional and somewhat hidden feature that the TDR rifles all have. And there is nothing worse than fumbling around trying to find a full magazine in your pocket when you're in the field. Air Arms has tucked a storage pocket on the underside, the underside of the cheek piece of the rear stock here, that is easily accessible with one-handed operation and changing out a magazine in the middle of the hunt. Well, that just got a whole lot easier. So what's not to like about this air gun? I know I've said a lot of positive things about this air gun and they're all well deserved. Matter of fact, I would be happy to have this air gun in my gun safe. But I also know that Air Arms is also going to be listening to this review. So I have 2 quick comments. One is first, I would absolutely love to see this with a small carbon fiber cylinder or bottle that has a little larger diameter for more airs. Because if we could get that shot count with the same power up to 40 or even 60 shots per fill, that would be outstanding. And you can add a aftermarket quick disconnect because filling this air rifle does require a special adapter. And I'd love to see Air Arms go to that. You can buy one as an aftermarket part. Air Arms, you might be able to save a little bit of money by changing that out. This all being said, I absolutely love the Air Arms TDR S510 XS. I would highly recommend this version to any air gunner that is in the market for something along these lines. It's accurate, it shoots well, the craftsmanship couldn't be any better, the bluing is magnificent. So, what's not to love, really? For those of you who have yet to do so, make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss any more of our reviews. And as always, make sure that trigger pull stays smooth, your pellets fly straight, and we'll see you next time on American Air Gunner.